Oh, he'll be serious. That's amazing.
Thank you, Rex.
Danny, you're a tremendous fighter. You have crazy power. Gennady just said you're his favorite fighter. What is that like, to step in the ring with someone who likes you?
I don't really know what that means. I don't know how to take that, but I take it as respect. We're both a gentleman outside the ring, so in that regards, I understand it. But come fight night, we're both not going to respect each other. We're both not going to be each other's favorite person in the world. So I'm excited about what we're going to bring to the table come fight night.
Everyone's excited about this fight. It doesn't matter what gym I'm at, what fighter I'm talking to, MMA or boxing. Right. What responses are you getting?
You know, a lot of people obviously are favoring Gennady Golovkin. His power is overshadowed a lot. What he brings to the table, the pressure, cutting off the ring. I can understand it. But like I said before, I wouldn't want to have it any other way. I wouldn't want people to favor me because the pot at the end of the rainbow wouldn't be filled. So I'm looking forward to stepping up. I'm looking forward to taking on the biggest challenge that people see. And I'm looking forward to proving everyone wrong and becoming the undisputed middleweight champion of the world.
What do you make of his power? Some people say hits like a middleweight, like Rosado told me that. Some people...
What do I make of his power? I've never been hit by him.
No, but do you think he hits like a middleweight, a super middleweight?
I don't know, man.
A heavyweight?
I hope I don't find out. I don't want to get hit. You know, no one wants to get hit. I want to be able to go in there and be dominant. And that's the key to boxing, is to hit and not get hit. That's the name of the game. So to question about his power, I have no idea. I'm just looking forward to doing everything I need to do to make sure I'm victorious, whatever it may be.
Canelo Chavez Jr., break it down if they fight.
If they fight, I think it's an amazing fight. I think it's a perfect fight, especially for the Mexican fans. And big shout out to the Mexican fans as well. They are the number one fans in boxing, in my opinion. So this fight will, in my opinion, be for them. And, you know, as far as matchup is concerned, both those guys don't take a step backwards. So it's going to be a great matchup as well. I like it personally, and I think it's great for boxing.
Last thing, who do you have as the top five pound-for-pound fighters right now?
Top five, Andre Ward, Shark Lilito. Hope I'm not missing anyone out. You have to put Triple G in there.
Danny Garcia?
Danny Garcia, yeah. Danny Garcia is, oh man, he's definitely top five, top ten, definitely for sure. But it's kind of hard. Everyone has their own opinions, but I'm a fan of the sport. I just like to see the sport thrive and be successful.
You're one of the nicest guys in the sport. I haven't met one person who doesn't like you. How do you do that and still be a champion and stay grounded and level-headed?
Because boxing is what I do. It's not who I am. You know, my grandmother raised me to, you know, she told me to, when you're out there, you represent yourself. You only represent your family as well. So make sure you do right by yourself. And I've always lived my life with that motto. And I've always made sure that my son has a great role model to follow behind. Like I said before, you see a totally different fighter once you're inside that ring. But when I come out, it's a smile on my face. And win, lose, or draw, I always have the utmost respect for my opponent, because the level of sacrifices that we all take to give people entertainment.
I gotta ask you this. Chris Brown, Soldier Boy. Mike Tyson,
man.
Your friend from Brownsville.
I love
said,
Mike.
He
I
said that he's
Mike.
Gonna train Chris Brown. So what do you think?
I think it's a bit controversial. If you ask me, I think fighters who risk their lives each and every day can maybe have an up and down opinion about it. But to say the least, I mean, I think it will be entertaining to see those guys go at it, because they don't really know how to fight or really box, so to actually see them go and perform, I think it'll be entertaining. But I do think that it shouldn't be like a pay-per-view, or if it is a pay-per-view, maybe they should give the proceeds or something like that to maybe a charity, or, you know, maybe the troops or something like that.
You
something
do a lot of that. You give a lot to charity.
Yeah, absolutely. I have my own foundation.
Tell people
actually.
About that.
Yeah, my
You've been
foundation.
Doing it for years.
Yeah, you know, I'm very, very heavily into the philanthropy world. We help out a lot of kids with cancer, and we teach kids also about health and nutrition, because obviously the things we put in our body trigger those cancer cells. So I'm very heavily into that. People want to find out what I do with my philanthropy work, they can go to my website. It's called www.getintheRing.net. And we have so many different ways where people can help and be supportive of what we do. But I love what I do. I love who I am outside the ring and the contribution that I have to my community.
A couple more and I'm done. I have to ask you this. Why is your Instagram handle Daniel Jacobs TKO? I thought it would be Daniel Jacobs KO.
Well, I don't mind TKO or TKO.
You'll take them both.
Yeah, exactly. I'll take them both.
Okay, my last question. Yeah. March 18th, the entire world will be tuning in onto you and Gennady Golovkin. What do you tell Gennady if he's watching this video?
What do I tell him? The same thing I've been telling everyone in the world. Don't sleep on Daniel Jacobs. My back is against the wall. You never know what you're going to find out.
Yeah, you have it. Daniel Jacobs. Stay tuned. March 18th. FiusReport.com. I'm Melissa back reporting.
Thank you.
Perfect. Hey. So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Eli Sekbak, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, at Sekbak. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Eli Sekbak.